Hello children, welcome back to today's session of online class of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. We are back with our same chapter 3. Today we will continue the accounting principle, rest of the accounting principle. Yesterday we have discussed 5 of the accounting principles. They were accounting entity or business entity concept, money measurement principle, accounting period principle, full disclosure principle and materiality principle. Now let us discuss some more principles or concepts. The 6th principle is the prudence or conservatism principle. This principle states that do not anticipate a profit but provide for all possible losses. We know that in a business there may be profit or loss, but according to this principle, every businessman should anticipate all the possible losses but don't anticipate a profit. They have to provide for all possible losses in a business but do not anticipate a profit. It is on the basis of this principle that closing stock, which is one of the asset, is recorded in the books of account. So while recording closing stock, there are two values, that is the cost and the net realizable. Net realizable value is also known as market value. So the cost value and the market value, whichever is lower, is considered as an amount for closing stock. So closing stock is recorded whichever is lower value, at the cost or market value. So it is recorded according to the principle of prudence. The 7th concept is cost concept or historical cost concept. They are known by these two names. According to the cost concept, an asset is recorded in the books of account at the price paid to acquire it. So when you record the asset in the balance sheet, you have to record the price of that asset, the price which you have paid to acquire it, and the cost is the basis for all the subsequent accounting of the assets. So further, whatever you are calculating related to that asset, as the base you will take the cost value. Okay, so that cost or the price paid to acquire that asset will be shown in the balance sheet in that asset side. So that is cost concept. Now matching concept or matching principle. This concept is based on the accounting period concept. Yesterday we saw that accounting period is classified into small intervals so that we can know about the profit or loss of the business or position of the business. So according to this concept, the expenses for an accounting period are matched against the related revenue rather than cash received or cash paid. Cash received or cash paid is not much important, as we want to know about the expenses and income generated by the business during that period. So during the accounting period, we have to check whether our expenses is equal to our revenue. So that is what matching concept is about. Next is dual aspect or duality principle. Our accounting work is based on all of this, that is on the basis of the dual aspect. According to the dual aspect, every transaction entered into by an enterprise have two aspects, a debit aspect and a credit aspect of equal amount. As you know, in accountancy we have two sides, that is debit side and credit side. So you have to see that both the side are equal, then only your problem is correct. So one more formula you have to remember, that capital or equities should be equal to your cash or asset. So capital should be equal to your assets. That is, if you are getting capital as 1 lakh, your asset side should also show as 1 lakh. So your debit and credit should show equal amount. One more definition is there. Owner's equity or capital. Capital is also known as owner's equity. Plus claim of outsiders, that is liability. Capital plus liability is equal to assets. Capital plus liability is equal to assets. So that is dual aspect. That is, our debit should be equal to the credit with equal amount. Revenue recognition concept is the next principle. According to this concept, revenue is recognized to have been realized when a transaction have been entered into and the obligation to receive the amount have been established. So when a revenue will be recognized? A revenue will be recognized when the transaction is taking place or when the transaction have been entered and it becomes obliged to the other party to pay the amount on the basis of the transaction. It is to be noted that recognizing revenue and receipt of an amount are two separate aspects. Receipt means what? Receipt means we are receiving the cash. Recognizing a revenue means what? Recognizing a revenue means a transaction is taking place where a revenue will be generated. So both this concept is separate one. That is, recognizing a revenue means it is not necessary that we receive the cash. A transaction have entered and revenue have been generated. But receipt means what? Actually cash is in the hand after the purchase or sale of a product. Now the next concept is verifiable objective concept. The verifiable objective concept holds that accounting should be free from personal bias. So an accountant's personal views should not be taken while accounting. It should be very scientifically done. So his personal bias or personal judgments have no place in accounting work. There must be objective evidence of transaction which are capable of verification. So every transaction which is entered in the book should be capable of verification. It means all accounting transactions should be evidenced and supported by business documents. So if a transaction is recorded in the books of accounts, the accountant should show the evidence or supported by a business documents. Like, what are the supporting documents? They can be cash memo, invoices, sales bill. So this evidence should be shown, or on the basis of this evidence, the accounting transaction should be recorded in the books of account and not with the personal bias of the accountant. So verifiable objective concept is the next principle. We have come to an end of this concept, that is accounting principle. In total, we have studied 11 concepts. So accounting's, the work in an accounting or the process of accounting is incomplete without the accounting principles. So whatever we record in the books of accounts are related to this principle or this concept. So children, you have to go through this concept, study it very thoroughly, as this is the base of accountancy. A test paper is attached along with this session. Please attend that question paper and answer it by 2 o'clock. Meet you in the next class with a new topic. Till then, goodbye.